Good afternoon. I think Mr. Kannan has covered everything. He didn't leave anything for me. Now I'll struggle. I thought I'll say thank you and go away. You see, this is not the first time, in fact, when I went to a conference on blue economy, and the issue of financing the blue economy came up. And when we discuss the financing part of blue economy, I see a certain degree of worry in the minds of people that we are talking so much about this important issue, but then where the money will come from. I think there's some, how I feel, when we start talking about the color, we tend to lose the context of blue economy, right? We get a bit, drawn into the shell, as we call, when we start talking about blue, right? People think, oh my God, this is probably a risky field, and as a result, we would not be able to find money. That's not true. Like, for example, I mentioned yesterday, the current estimated value or value addition in ocean economy, which you can call blue economy, I can come to that a bit later, it is $2.5 trillion, which means we are creating a blue value to the tune of $2.5 trillion. That means the money is there, right? Simple, for example, we have been doing shipping for ages. Somebody invests money there. We do tourism, coastal tourism, somebody spends money there. We have been doing hydrocarbons, somebody spends money there. For that matter, all the aspects of blue economy or ocean economy, that means people have been spending money, investing money into those sectors for ages, right? For ages. Now, for example, there is an asset value estimation, which I mentioned yesterday, $24 trillion. Now, if those are the assets we are talking about, and my estimation is that is a gross underestimation of the asset value of blue part of the economy. Now, if it is, even if it's about $24 trillion, isn't it sufficient attraction for people to invest? I have simply no reason to believe that there will be difficulty finding money. In fact, when we launched what is called the Sustainable Development Goals, when we started talking about what is called green economy, let's now go to another color which is very similar to blue, but it's a predecessor of the blue. And at that point, the idea was, okay, we'll do the same thing. We'll do tourism, we'll do shipping, we'll do ports, we'll do hydrocarbons, we do everything that we have been doing, but we will do in a more greener manner. Now, that was just about reconfiguration of the tools that we were using, not necessarily an additional or new investment. Could we recalibrate our approach? That was more important. And as a result, just imagine in 2010, some bright fellow thought, okay, let's go for what is called the green bonds, the idea of green bonds. And then once we had the climate change discussions, somebody came out with this idea of having climate aligned bonds, right? Now, can you imagine in 2007, there was the green bonds or the climate aligned bonds did not exist, right? And in 2018, what was the value of climate aligned bonds? It was $218 billion. $218 billion were raised by different organizations and banks only in 2018 through what is called the climate-aligned bonds. And according to the latest reports, nearly $1 trillion are being invested into what is called the sustainable development projects, sustainable projects all over the world. Now, $1 trillion is already pouring into those projects, and we think we are worried about money. You know, once we are able to convince the investor that this is good business, the money will come. And that is what we are trying to do as part of this exercise of the task force with FICCI. We are trying to make out a case to the business community that there is money in this process. Don't run away and thinking, oh my God, as if this whole process will become a drain on their resources. No, it's going to be a force multiplier. In fact, there is an OECD report which says, though they are only talking about what is called the direct blue economy, not really the downstream or the upstream. They say by 2030, if we do business the way we do now, which means we don't care for blue or green, we simply do what we do, right? We are looking at the ocean-driven economy at something about $2.8 trillion. But then they say, if you pay attention to being blue, which means if you are more sustainable, this turnout will be $3.2 trillion. $3.2 trillion, which means when you are more sustainable, you do better with the same resources. Now, that is the idea we are supposed to take to the business community, that sustainability means better business, in fact. Not worse. It is a better business. And I personally feel that all these estimates are on the conservative side because we do not understand the concept so well right now. As I mentioned yesterday, for example, tourism alone, if we take the downstream and the upstream part of the economy, today this sector is $8 trillion. $8 trillion. Somebody has put that money there. That is why the sector is $8 trillion, right? And the estimate is that by 2028, which means exactly in 10 years, the sector is going to be $12.4 trillion. We are going to add more than $4 trillion to the sector. Somebody is going to invest that money. Similarly, in fishing, for example, I mentioned yesterday, there is going to be an additional demand for something about 32 million metric tons of fish. And most of that fish will be produced through aquaculture, in fact. And we have such a wonderful experience of dealing with aquaculture. We can capture a very large part of that market. And in terms of money, though they have not, in fact, given the value because we do not know how much the fish will cost 10 years from now or what kind of species we are using. But in a very conservative estimate would be something about $100 billion. Now, do you want to take advantage of $100 billion? I'm sure there are people who want to take advantage of $100 billion. And they will raise money and bring it to those sectors, right? So, in fact, if you ask me, I am not really very worried about finding money for good projects. And there are so many good projects. You can take it to the port sector. You can take it to the shipping. You can take it to any sector of blue economy. Kanan Saab, do you agree with me or no? You are a businessman. Tell me, am I making sense? That it is good business. And therefore, the money will come. Now, the question is, if I'm giving the good news that money is not going to be a problem, then what is the problem? Why we are discussing it? Right? The worry which we have is that, as I said, for example, convincing the business community about sustainability is a bit of a more difficult task, right? The problem will arise mainly in three sectors. First sector is R&D, research and development. Now, businessmen may not really come forward and spend money from their own pocket in doing research, right? This is one. The second is capacity building. of the system. They may not want to spend money in capacity building and creating skills, right? And the third is creating what is called writing your laws of blue economy. Because a new sector, we have to write laws. I'm sure Dr. Rajan sitting there will agree with me that a lot of laws have to be written. How this whole thing will be run in terms of legal systems. And then is what is called the compliance cost. Because people get scared of the compliance cost. We in fact had a discussion on the waterways and there was a heated argument what should be done and what should not be done. Which means there will be a compliance cost. But put together R&D, capacity building, legislative capacity building and compliance cost, in my view, will be a very small percentage of the total kitty. If you ask me, I'm also a scientist by background, right, and a diplomat by practice. I would not put this cost at more than 5% total, right? And where will this 5% come? And that is where I think part of it will come through, of course, the private sector, because there is private sector now willing to spend money on R&D and also using their corporate social responsibility kitty, which is now sufficiently large. That money will have to be partly financed through, you said, the private-public partnership, and that component could be the public component. Because I, in fact, made a case, for example, we are discussing about a new field called marine biotechnology, which is a very, very new field. It's just emerging. You know, when we studied that sector, we discovered that the European companies have already extracted more than 100,000 metabolites and are in the process of testing them for their pharmaceutical applications and in the process of then creating patents for them. Now, you know, we all know that when it comes to the modern age pharmaceuticals, the kind of money the private sector can make on those patents, right? It's a huge amount of money, right? And if we don't work on that, if we do not work on that now, it will be late. Because these are the same metabolites which are in our ocean and elsewhere. Now, if somebody finds those metabolites somewhere else, they study them, they patent them, then even if you find them in Indian Ocean, doesn't really matter because you can do nothing, right? So I think on those sectors, we'll have to really convince ourselves that this investment will have to be done by the public sector in majority, right? In majority, this will have to be done by public sector. But that is not a very big deal. We have, in fact, already very large departments with very large budgets for that R&D, right? We take pride in saying we are, in fact, the third largest scientifically trained manpower. We say that in technology, we are a superpower. Now, if you really want to remain a superpower in technology, we have to invest, right? So, in fact, if you ask me, I am not really very worried about finding money, except, as I said, those small part of the whole investment kitty, research and development, capacity building, and the compliance cost. And in my view, that is not really a big deal. This will be about 3-4% of the total investment. And considering the returns we are looking at, it is really a negligible amount. With these words, I will stop here unless you have questions, because this is a very wide area and most of the practical parts have already been covered by my colleague, Mr. Kanan. So I just wanted to agitate your mind that at the end of the day, finding money for blue economy will not be a big deal. The money will be there. We have to just make a case to the business community that there is good business